This is our Forex blog for April 3rd, 2015, and we released a new version today over the weekend, and this is the first release in 2 weeks. We put in some major changes. Not only have I added probably 75 to 80 new patterns, I've also fixed probably 20 or 30 of the older ones that were giving us trouble, and we also made major changes to how we cache data. So it loads much faster, much more responsive, and while it's loading, you can also move the charts around a lot better than before. I'm just going to showcase some of the charts, and it's very selective in the trades that it takes. You can see on Thursday, it had a nice little win here. The market kind of double topped and the trend reversed. It went lower than the previous little swing, and so we looked to therefore sell Fibonacci areas. We're always measuring the statistical strength or weakness and whether price actually proves it's strong or weak by going above and below previous swings. And we're a big believer and heavy user of Fibonacci levels, especially the 15-62% level. And I usually only take those trades when enough time has elapsed too. So if the market's just going nuts and haywire and there's 20 or 30 bars every minute, we tend to stay out of the market because it's less predictable. So you can see it keeps making new lows and we're looking to sell. Basically, a lot of our patterns have 25 up to 50 plus rules, and you know, we don't like to buy after market has gone up a lot without enough time elapsing. Frequently, I'm looking when a new high is made for a two-wave pullback, so we go down, up, comes down again, then we look to get in. It's usually much safer than buying the first pullback, and you can see this is good for almost 40 pips. Just showcase a few other charts and then show you the stats that I've been keeping. Here's the euro yesterday. It had a very small loss here. I'm putting in a new pattern that actually buys here because it is a new low. I'm sorry, new high. And it also, one of our tools is our intraday FX trend value areas. Let's see where that is. And it shows you the whatever time period you want. I like the 16 to 4 hours. What this does is it shows you where most trades happened during the previous period. In this case, it's the previous 4 hours. So one of the things on this trade is it went up, pulled back, tried to go higher, and then came down. It went right to a Fibonacci profit target of this first wave. It went to the 1.618 and stopped. And it also happened to stop at the previous 4 hours point of control. Point of control is where it spent the most time, the price that was most traded during the previous 4 hours. And it's a very significant level, and it acts as major support resistance. If it comes down to this level and stalls, especially at a Fibonacci profit target, it tends to continue with the trend. In this case, it went up 80 or 90 pips. So this is a pattern I've just coded up. It didn't finish. Quitting for the day. I work every single day of the week. It's Sunday that I'm recording this video, but this will be in the next release, this particular pattern. Getting back to this one, very strong trend. Again, enough bars and time goes by that we look to buy the pullback, and again, good for a decent number of pips on that trade. And the market kind of jerks around in a very unorganized way, and therefore we don't take any more trades. Here's another one that we took something similar to what I was looking to do with the euro dollar. It just makes new highs, pulls back, comes up again, and usually anytime a new high or a swing high hits one of these fib targets, it's a very good place to be buying a double bottom on the pullback. So in this particular case, this is one of the patterns I look for. A new high was made for the day, and it pulls back to a previous swing low. A double bottom does work, you know, a little over 55% of the time. When they're in the direction of the trend, but right after a new day's high is made, it tends to be very profitable, and you can see this one led to an absolutely huge move. In fact, you can, that particular pattern is called index 176, and it was good for 85 pips. These stats that I'm doing are after the fact. I look at each day, I fix a lot of the bad patterns, the ones that historically don't tend to give big wins or don't have a very high winning percentage. I fix those, I add new patterns for the day, And these are the stats after that. So there obviously, before I kept these stats, there were some losses that I fixed. And there was also some of these patterns that hit in these stats. I just coded them up yesterday. So if you had the software before, these trades wouldn't have existed at that time. So it's the way I do the stats. And you can take them with a grain of salt, but you will find over time a lot of these patterns tend to repeat in very similar ways. You know, my goal is 60% or higher at winning. And I also am looking for trades that are 1.5 to 2 times bigger when they work versus when they don't work. So you can see on this day, the average win was huge because of a couple big 50-plus pip wins, 34 pip average win. The average loss was under 5 pips. Most days, the average loss is anywhere from 7 to 9. I do not like the average loss when it gets over 10, and I tend to spend more time fixing the trades that cause that. And this day didn't have a super high winning percentage compared to some of them. The day before, I fixed 3 or 4 of the losses and added a bunch of new patterns, but there was not a single loss. It's the only 100% day we've ever had since I've been keeping stats since last November. Huge day, 398 pips, 22 pip average win. This is somewhere between 17 and 25 is where it runs, and because there's no losses, the average pip was there. You can see the previous day, 81% winning. Very happy with that. I fixed a bunch of losing patterns. There's like 5 or 6. So if you subtract the 5 or 6 new patterns I did and the ones I fixed, it was probably closer to 50% winning earlier in the day, and probably only netted about 200 pips or 150 to 200. But nonetheless, regardless, you know, after getting rid of some of the losers and adding new patterns, this is the result. So take this with a grain of salt. I'm just showing you the progress of it over time. And I look at progress in terms of not only the results in real trading, but also how the number of pips per week seems to be going up every few weeks. The number of pips for that week tends to go up. And for the last few months, it's usually over 1,000 for the week. So I'm very happy with the progress. When I first kept stats after working on it for 6 months, the win percentage was closer to 40% after I was done for the day. So the fact that it went from 40 to oftentimes over 60, very happy. I think this was Wednesday, and you can see also a very high winning percentage. A lot lower number of net pips because there wasn't too many super big wins, but I'm happy with a slew of, you know, 8 to 20 pip wins. Very happy with that. And this is a very good Sunday Monday. Usually most Sunday Mondays do under 200 pips, sometimes under 100 pips even. So this was an exceptionally good Sunday Monday. And there wasn't that many big losses, none of them over 10. The average loss is under 4. And there's quite a few big wins over 30 pips. So that increased the average. There's now over 1,600 different patterns that are in here, and I keep stats, as you can see, and the ones that give me trouble I put stars next to, and when they pop up in the future I take screenshots of them. Like this one right here, it tends to not be a very good pattern. NR break 90, it lost 8 pips that day, and after I get about 5 or 10 pictures of that going into the future, especially a bunch of pictures of the wins and what they have in common, pictures of the losses, what they have in common, I try to put in extra rules that try to keep some of the big wins while getting rid of, you know, more and more of these 8 to sometimes 15 pip losses. And patterns that historically have a lot of 20, 30, and 40 pip wins in the past and have a bad day, I tend to leave alone. If in the future that changes and the stats react poorly on a particular pattern, then I will add new rules to those. But this is a very big upgrade today, version 5.020, because I've fixed a few of my problem patterns that I've been working on for months. I wanted to get enough trades before I could see what the exceptional winners had in common and what the losers had in common. And usually, the ones that lost were when the market was just explosively too high up or too high down or too low. And so I put in rules to prevent that, and it will take the, you know, the trades like this where it's just kind of drifting up slowly, explodes up, pulls back, takes the trade. A lot of times when the market's just going up, 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 buying the pullback right near the high, like for instance, if you bought right here, you would tend to lose. And in this one right here, it was a very small loser. those are the riskier trades, and those are the ones that I tend to put in extra rules to fix. So go, when you load the new or the software, it will ask you to auto update. Hit yes, and you'll get the new version automatically. And that's it for this blog. I'm just focusing on trading, improving the systems, and this week I am now also adding value areas, which will let me see where the price has spent the most time during the previous hour and the previous 4 hour, and it's going to help me find trades like this that I really don't have any safe way of doing so now. You're going to see major improvements in the accuracy of our signals and a ton of new patterns that are going to hit more frequently because I don't have to have so many strict rules, because this is one of the best rules that we have. And we're very big proponents of value area technology, and we've built that in the software. I do use the daily value areas, weekly value areas, and now I'm also going to have the previous hours and previous, in this case, previous 4 hours value area.